Hi, hello, good morning students, welcome back. Today we will see chapter number 9 from history, that is the making of regional cultures. We are going to see part 1. Let's see the topics. The Cheras and the development of Malayalam. Chera, one of the existing you can say the kingdom in the southern part of India, as well as the growth and development of Malayalam as a language. Let's see the topics or subtopics. The commonmost way of describing people is in terms of the language they speak. Of course, yes, if they are speaking any Hindi or North Indian languages, we can easily describe them as North Indians or Bengalis, Assamese, okay, and if any South Indian languages, as Madrasis in common, okay, and that is the reason that we can differentiate people by the language they speak. We also tend to associate each region with the distinctive kinds of food, clothes, then poetry, dance, music and painting. So if we see the food habits of North India, South India, then Eastern part of India, Western part of India, so we differentiate the region with their distinctive, with their special kind of food. Then it may be the clothes, it may be the poetry, it may be the dance form, music. Say for example, our own Gujarat. So, is famous for Dokla Khaman on one hand, and then clothes is a different variety. Surat is famous for as a textile industry, Ahmedabad also. And distinctive type of clothes, especially the people of Kutch, Gujarati people, the costume they wear is a distinctive type, and then poetry, then dance form, especially Navratri, Garbha, then music as well as painting, so varli painting and all. The Chera kingdom of Mahodayapuram. So I told you that Chera was an existing flourishing kingdom of the southern part of India. So the kingdom of Mahodayapuram was established in the 9th century in the southwestern part of peninsula. It is the part of present day Kerala. So Chera kingdom or you can say of Mahodayapuram is their capital, and it was found in the present day Kerala. The rulers introduced Malayalam as the language in their script. So while writing, they used Malayalam as the language for writing. Cheras also drew upon Sanskritic traditions. The first literary work of Malayalam or in Malayalam is dating back to about 12th century are directly indebted to Sanskrit. So whatever the written work was found way back to 12th century, it was directly indebted to Sanskrit. Sanskrit se liya gaya tha aur Sanskrit se uska connection tha. Leela Tilakam, dealing with grammar and politics, referred to Sanskrit and the regional language. So Leela Tilakam is a work written and it deals with grammar as well as politics, and it referred to Sanskrit as well as regional language Malayalam. Now the next slide says the rulers and religious traditions, the Jagannatha cult. Regional cultures grew around religious traditions. Religious traditions. So different religions have their own traditions, their own rules and regulations. For example, the Jagannatha cult. You remember Jagannatha, Lord Jagannatha, isn't it? So it's associated with Puri, Lord Jagannatha temple at Puri. Puri is in Odisha. Then Anantavarman dedicated to erect a temple for Purushottama Jagannatha at Puri. So who decided, who decided to erect a temple is none other than Anantavarman at Puri, Jagannatha at Puri. As the temple gained popularity as a pilgrimage center, its authority in social and political matters also increased. Nowadays, it is one of the most attracted tourism place, or you can say the pilgrimage center or pilgrimage place. Those who follow the you can say even ISKCON wale wo sab to usme jaate hain Jagannatha at Puri. And people are visiting from all over the world Jagannatha Puri. It is in Odisha. Then Mughals, Marathas and the British tried to control the temple to make their rule acceptable to the local people. So all these the different foreign powers, they tried to control the temple and make their rule acceptable to the local people. Local people means the people of Odisha, or you can say the people, or you can say Odishi people. Now the next slide says the Rajputs and the traditions of heroism. Rajput, they are always famous for their valor and their heroism, bravery and all. So now let's come to that. The present day Rajasthan was called Rajputana in the 19th century. Rajputs contributed to the distinctive culture of Rajasthan. Prithviraj, you might have heard Prithviraj Chauhan, was one of the most cherished rulers who chose death on the battlefield rather than face defeat. What this sentence is, Prithviraj Chauhan being one of the important ruler among the Rajputs, and he preferred to death rather than facing defeat by his enemies. Stories about Rajput heroes were recorded in the poems and songs which inscribe people even today. So many stories describing the Rajputs, their bravery and all, is described in their poems also, and it is existing and inspiring the people even today. Women figured as the cause of conflict. मतलब सबके झगड़े का कारण women ऐसा होता था, figured as the cause of conflict, as men fought with one another either to win or to protect women. So for two reasons there used to be, you can say, quarrel, or you can say war. The main cause is being women, either to protect her or to win her. तो समटाइम्स क्या होता था, तो उस टाइम में ऐसा होता था कि उससे शादी करना है, प्रिंसेस से शादी करना है, तो युद्ध होता था, और युद्ध में जो जीत जिसकी होती थी उसके साथ शादी होती थी. या फिर समटाइम्स ऐसा भी होता था, टू प्रोटेक्ट वुमेन देर यूज टू बी वॉर एमंग द राजपूत्स और विद द एनिमीज. Women are also depicted as following their heroic husbands in both life and death. Just like their men's are hero, so women also depicted that following their heroism by committing sati. Now what is sati system? Soon after the death of the husband, due to any reason, it may be due to disease, it may be due to war, or any reason for that matter, she used to, or his widow, she used to jump into the funeral pyre of her husband. Sati ke matlab pati ke saath sahagaman karna, ya fir apna pran tyag karna. कैसे प्राण त्याग करना, जो पति का जो चिता जलता हुआ चिता जो है उसी के ऊपर जंप करके, टू जंप इनटू द फ्यूनरल पायर ऑफ हर हस्बैंड, शी यूज्ड टू कमिट सती. एंड दैट इज़ व्हाई इट आल्सो शोज द वैलर, ब्रेवरी एंड जस्ट इक्वल टू हर हस्बैंड. Sati system, as I told you just now explained, was prevalent among the Rajput women. So that is Sati system. Now, next one, beyond regional frontiers, we have studied about the Chera kingdom, the Malayalam as a language, and on other side, the western part, that is the Rajputs, the Rajputana, and important ruler being Prithviraj Chauhan, and the Rajputs, they famous for their heroism, bravery, valor, and it is depicted in their poems, and women were also equal in showing the bravery by committing sati soon after the death of their husbands. So this is about the regional one. Now let's come to the regional beyond, matlab uske alawa, the regional frontiers, the story of Kathak. Kathak, you know, as it is one of the dance form, so there are Indian dance form, okay, there are 6 different dance forms are there in India, and Kathak is one among them. So let us see this one first, and later on we will see the different dance forms of India. Okay, come to the point. Different dance forms can be seen in different traditions in different regions. Yes, Assam famous for Assamese, Manipur for Manipuri, so Andhra Pradesh Kuchipudi, Bharatanatyam Tamil Nadu, like that. The Kathak, a dance form, is associated in North India. It is derived from a Sanskrit word Katha. Katha means story. It's a storytelling. That means the dance form is in such a way that it story is not being orally told. Story is enacted through a dance form. Kathaks were originally a caste of storytellers in the temples of North India. Actually, they were one of the caste, and which caste? Storytellers caste in the North India. It evolved means developed into a dance form in the 15th and 16th centuries, and with the spread of bhakti movement. भक्ति में क्या होता है कि गाने के साथ साथ जो भाव प्रकट करते हैं थ्रू, आप देखा होगा इस्कॉन वाले करते हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण करके वो डांस फॉर्म करते हैं, फिर इतना घूमते हैं, इतना भाव परवश हो जाते हैं, एंड दैट इज दैट इन स्लोली इन द सेम वे Kathak also evolved in such a dance form because of the bhakti movement. Let's see more. This is a dance form that Kathak, you might have seen this, or some of you might be girls are learning also. The legend of folk play Ras Leela. Folk matlab, you know, folk dance, local jo hai, play means drama. Ras Leela by Radha Krishna were enacted by combining folk dance with the basic gestures of Kathak. Gesture matlab kuch uska, jaise ki apne wo previous mein ye dekha, this is one of the gesture, haath aur uska pair ka like movement hi hota hai uska. Bharatanatyam mein bahut elaborate hota hai, but Kathak is restricted. Uska just ye wala portion aur pair ka jo ho, that plays a very important role. Isse kehte hai ki gesture. And the what I was telling, that folk dance or iska gesture ko mila ke Ras Leela by Radha Krishna were enacted, as the story was enacted. It was performed in the Mughal court and it acquired its distinctive style there. So Mughals, in those days there were no source of entertainment other than music and dance. So these were enacted in the Mughal court and it got the distinctive place or style. It developed in two traditions. Two traditions mean two gharana hota hai. One is in the court of Rajasthan and another in the court of Lucknow. So Kathak ka two gharana hai. One is the Lucknow gharana and another one is the Rajasthan gharana. It grew as a major art form under the Nawab of Awadh Wajid Ali Shah. So it grew as an art form ban gaya. Then it later spread to present day Punjab, then Haryana, Jammu and Kashmir, Bihar and Madhya Pradesh. So it spread, you can say, all over the north and the central part of India. the British administrator did not favor this cultural tradition. Yes, they did not encourage. And independent India recognized this as one of the six classical dance form of India. After 1947, when we got independence, we I can say started respecting or recognizing Kathak as one of the dance form of India. Now let's see the other five dance forms of India are, one is Bharatanatyam, as most of you are aware about this dance form. Then Kuchipudi is mainly, as I told you, grew in Andhra Pradesh and then Telangana portion, and then some part of Odisha also, maybe Manipuri, Manipur and all, Assam and all. Then Odishi in Odisha, then Kathakali. Kathakali means, is Kali means is a game, but it's not a game. So it's again wearing heavy costumes and you are performing. And in Kathakali, as you know that the it is depicted through your eye expressions or expressions over this portion only, aise karke, with heavy costumes and makeup. So Katha, you know, Katha means story, Kali means game. It's game nahi hai, to usko again it's a mixture of some part of using hand movement as well as leg movement, little bit of Kathak ka jaisa bhi lagta hai aur little bit Bharatanatyam ka bhi thoda bahut haath par aise karke, but heavy costumes with I can say with your facial expression. So that is Kathakali, especially in Kerala. So these are the five different dance form, and sixth one is being Kathak. Next one is painting for patterns. The tradition of miniature. Miniature, as you know, the word miniature means very small, isn't it? Small. Miniatures are small sized paintings, generally done in watercolor on clothes or paper. So that is called miniature painting. The earliest miniatures were on palm leaves or on wood. That is the first one, either on the palm or on wood. Now on paper or on cloth. The Mughal emperors like Akbar, Jahangir, then Shah Jahan patronized highly skilled painters. Patronized means protsa diya, unko sanman diya, unko encourage kiya, who illustrated, matlab developed aur usko exhibit kiya, illustrated manuscripts containing historical accounts and poetry. Manuscripts were already written on palm leaves, and these miniature painters usko ek साथ साथ में उसका पिक्चर बना के उसको एक, अभी हम क्या करते हैं कि यू कैन सी द इमेजेस ऑन दैट ऑन योर टेक्स्ट बुक, यू कैन सी द इमेजेस अलॉन्ग विद द स्टोरी, अलॉन्ग विद द टॉपिक यू कैन सी द स्टोरी ऑल्सो, पिक्चर्स ऑल्सो. And in those days, the pictures were not there. Now we can see the directly photos are being taken, videos are being, or I can say added. But in those days, सिर्फ literally work था, तो उसको associated कुछ scenery बनाते थे या कुछ उसका painting बनाते थे, and these manuscripts or I can say miniature painters उसको करते थे. That's why on palm leaves or on the wood. And especially these rulers they gave because they wanted to have some historical record with them. In those days photography was not there. Then portraits of rulers, so ruler ka portrait ho, then court scene, court ka kuch acha sa scene ho, and the themes from mythology, maybe from Ramayana, Mahabharat or from any other mythology. And poetry began to be depicted in the form of miniature painting. Later, Himalayan foothills developed a bold and intense style of miniature paint called Basoli. That is Basoli painting. And later on, what happened when the Mughals' kingdom was slowly diminished, then these artists, earlier they were encouraged and they were given place in the Mughal court. Now the Mughal rule is no more in existence. So they slowly now shifted to Himalayan foothills, and there they developed their miniature painting, and that is called as Basoli painting. The attacks of Nadir Shah, Afghanistan say, and Central Asia forced the Mughal artists to migrate. So as I told you, the Mughal Empire ही नहीं रहा, Emperor नहीं रहा, तो artist को कौन वो उत्साह देने वाले, प्रोत्साहन देने वाले, पैसा देने वाले, कोई नहीं था. Then they shifted to the Himalayan foothills, which led to the founding of Kangra School of Painting. Kangra, note it. So that's all, students, for today. We'll see in our next class more about the next topics. Keep in the meantime, keep reading. Yes, reading textbook is very, very important. Okay, so keep reading and keep studying and stay home and stay safe. Bye bye. Have a nice time. Okay, have a nice time and take care of yourself.